video, we'll be looking at how to back up your Vertex AI Workbench instances. If you're not familiar with Vertex AI Workbench, these are Jupyter notebooks running on the Vertex AI service and managed by Google Cloud. This gives you access to accelerators like GPUs and TPUs and allows you to develop quickly and easily with minimal infrastructure work. However, because this is a managed service, it does present some questions about how to handle backups. Let's explore that together. The first thing we want to do is go to the Vertex AI service. You can either search for that or find it in the menu and enable all the recommended APIs, which will include Compute Engine and some APIs related to the Workbench offering specifically. Once we're set, let's go to the Workbench service and create a few workbenches across the different notebook types. There are three types. The last two are the legacy ways, and Instances is the new version that combines the best of both. Let's create an instance, not spending too much time configuring it. We'll spin up the default settings across the different notebook types. As these spin up, check which are visible in Compute Engine. We have three notebook types representing varying levels of management. In Compute Engine, you'll see two instances running, the user-managed notebook and the new instance type. You can deduce from the naming that these are our user-managed notebooks and semi-managed instances. The fully managed instance doesn't show up in Compute Engine because it's part of Google Cloud and run in a Google project. Ready to dive into the Jupyter world? Now that we've launched an instance, let's navigate to Jupyter. It may seem familiar, like ordinary Jupyter Lab, but with a Vertex AI Workbench flair. We've unlocked exciting features like an automated BigQuery system, a Git plugin, a notebook scheduler, and under settings, properties for activity logs and bugs. There are also standard functions in the top menu for saving, downloading, notebooks, running cells, working with kernels, Git controls, and standard settings. It's important to integrate a standard source control system into your notebook. Imagine initiating Git, then integrating notebooks and Python scripts into the repository. This provides a natural mechanism for code versioning and restoration. Thinking of a digital safety net beyond Git, look to the Artifact Registry system for backups. Here we can store assets like Docker containers, Python packages, or Kubeflow pipelines. Keep in mind, the Artifact Registry is for artifact assets, not file systems or datasets. So while it can be part of your backup strategy, it'd probably make sense in addition to, not instead of, other forms of backups. Next, let's look at the Compute Engine layer. Here, we have two instances that can tap into the Disaster and Recovery Service for a comprehensive backup and disaster recovery system, including Google Cloud VMs. Compute Engine is an important piece of the backup chain since the notebooks are built on standard Compute Engine instances. For a simpler option, let's go to Compute Engine and build snapshots of our disks. If we accidentally delete data from our file system, we can restore it. Bear in mind, deleting an instance generally leads to deletion of the disk and its snapshots. You may want to consider cloning the disk before deleting the instance. We also have the snapshot schedule feature to customize daily or hourly backups. If needed, we can create machine images from our instances for a system-level backup, including the disks. That covers the multi-layered backup system for your Jupyter work. However, remember that our notebooks and VM instances are different. In Vertex AI Workbench, the managed notebooks and the Google managed project offer limited options. The interfaces are turnkey, but also inflexible. In a pinch, and as a last resort, consider setting up the schedule feature, allowing your notebooks to run a backup job on a preset timeline. It's clumsy and not ideal, but an option worth noting. We hope you found this video helpful. We'll keep an eye on the comments for any questions. Thank you for tuning in, and please enjoy responsibly.